it's one of those days today. It's about 90 degrees. I'm in Charlotte, North Carolina. This is how they left my trailer. So now I gotta crawl under the trailer. I crank the landing gear down. And I got that much room to work. This ain't gonna be good, man. Gotta love it. Holiday weekend. Well, it just isn't my day today. Not only does my hair look like this, but I hooked up to my trailer and I couldn't get it to move, and there was only a few inches between it and the trailer next to it. So I dropped that trailer, or unhooked from it, I thought, and moved over one spot to hook up to the next trailer, but I forgot to take my red air line off, which is the supply line for the trailer. So thankfully I caught it before it broke off, so that would have sucked, because then I would have spent half a day trying to find a new hose and get it put on. But anyway, rookie move, baby, rookie move. I got hooked up to the right trailer, and I got moved over a little bit. This is a trailer I had to move, and if you look at the blue line, how nice and curly that is. That red line used to be curly, and now it's nice and straight. So, but it didn't break off. So I'm gonna do a field repair, and then I'll show you that when I get it done, and that should get me home, where I can go and do the walk of shame into the shop at the yard there and have them slap a new red line on. Usually they have to do both though, so they match. So hopefully I get good ones again. My mistake, no question. So I finished my field repair, and it's not the most attractive thing, but it's functional. I don't know if I'll try to get home with it. Let me out here. What I did, as you can see, is I just took some Gorilla Tape and I coiled it up and I put it on there. Well, I had to worry about this bracket right here. I didn't want to hook this while I was going down the road. So I put a bungee cord up here and hooked it around this. So this carries the weight, but it's also flexible, so it'll give it a little bit of play. I put this hose through here, through the blue line, so it wouldn't hang down and draw attention at the scales, which I'm sure it will. But I have a pretty flexible thing here. It's got some give in it, so when I turn, it should go. Hopefully everything will stay in place till I get back to the yard. Yeehaw. Gotta love it, man. Gotta love it. Trucking 101.
truck originally belonged to Gibbs Racing.
Oh, okay.
Tony Stewart.
Oh.
And Jim Sercom bought it from him, and then I got it from
Sercom. Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I've got on my YouTube channel, I've got an interview with Mr. Sercom. The whole family is really nice up in St. Ignace. So what's in this thing?
550 cap, 18 speed.
Nice.
Cool.
It's got a million miles.
Oh, it looks nice. You never know. Cool. All right. Well, Steve, thanks for coming on here.
All right. Yep.
Appreciate it.
I thought you might like to know that's where it came from.
Yeah, that's cool. Good to have the history on.
Because it still has Gibbs Racing embroidered in the seats.
Oh, no kidding.
Yeah.
Can I get a shot of that? All right. This thing disappears when you get out in the sun, man. You can't see a thing.
Yeah.
I got a
Jimmy Schaefer going up to the